our Lord and Savior is a black man. Give me one word, man. He's a black man. And what do you think that black man is coming back to do? Huh? He coming back to do what? You damn right he's coming back.
That's right.
Because his people need saving. Right. The other nations need saving, so the white man needs saving.
Freedom!
That's what this Bible is all about.
Israelites according to the Bible.
That's right.
That is who we are.
You know why men, black men kill each other? Because they don't see each other as Jesus Christ.
Yeah, Israelites from the time of the Jews. Let's look to Hebrews 7 and 14.
Because they don't see each other as Jesus Christ.
Because they don't see each
other as Jesus Christ. Our people hate God. You know why they hate God? Because you see, as that little young girl walking with that white girl, that's what they love most of all.
Right.
They love their oppressor. Read.
Romans chapter 10 and verse 1. Brethren, my heart's desire and prayer to God for Israel is that they might be saved.
God want our people to be saved.
Right.
He want our people to come over here and hear the truth. He want our people to turn from sin. He want our people to come out these ghettos. He wants us to come out the hell that we in. But the reason why we never do is because we listening to our oppressor tell us how we can rise up.
That's the problem.
We going to our oppressor to find out how we gonna be saved, how we can change our lives, but instead of coming to the word of God.
Right.
Read.
For I bear them record.
He bear record. This is the record. It's telling you about our people. Read.
That they have a zeal of God.
Our people got a zeal of God. If I ask every Negro out here, do they love God? What you think they're gonna say? They're gonna say they love God. They're all gonna lie, period.
Right.
But what?
But not according to knowledge.
But not according to what?
But not according to knowledge.
But not according to knowledge. Because guess what? He asked you, was this Jesus Christ? Is this Christ? This is what was given to us, right? This is what was given to us. And our people, guess what? You never seen your great-great-grandfather, right? But you know he ain't white. So let's find out what color Christ is. Give me that in Revelation. Because guess what? As a matter of fact, start Revelation 1 and 1. Because since you've been blessed today, and I'm going to prove it to you, I'm going to show you in prophecy that you've been blessed today. Read
Revelation chapter 1 and verse 1.
Read it out.
The revelation of Jesus Christ.
The revealing of Jesus Christ. Read.
Which God gave unto him to show unto his servants.
To show to who?
To his servants.
Guess what, sis? You called to be a servant.
That's right.
So you had to hear this word.
Right.
Read.
Things which must shortly come to pass.
Uh-huh.
And he sent and signified it by his angel unto his servant John.
Read.
Who bear record?
Who did what?
Who bear record?
This is the record of Jesus Christ that we're reading today. Read.
Of the word of God.
Uh-huh.
And of the testimony of Jesus Christ.
Read.
And of all things that he saw.
Read.
Blessed is he that readeth.
Blessed is he that what?
Blessed is he that readeth.
Read.
And they that hear the words of this prophecy.
And they that what?
That hear the words of this prophecy.
What's your name, sis? Nakanda. Are you hearing the words of this prophecy? Are you hearing what Christ is going to be revealed?
Bring it up.
Give me verse 14. Let's hear how he's going to be revealed. Let's find out what the color of Christ is. Because we all love Christ. We all acknowledge that he's our king. So let's find out what our king look like.
Bring
our king still going to be a damn oppressor of our people? Or is he going to be one of us? Read.
Verse 14. His head and his hair were white like wool.
His head and his hairs were white like wool. Does he have white woolly hair? Who got woolly hair on this earth? Look around you. What is that? Is that woolly hair? Woolly hair is hair of Negro.
That's right.
Guess what? Would the white men fall in that category? No. Read.
As white as snow.
I mean, it was fully gray, so the hair on his head and the hair on his face was white in color and wool in texture. So guess what? Our Christ, our Savior, looks like you.
That's right!
And only our oppressor would give you a lie. Guess what came with that false image? A false doctrine.
Right.
Lies came with this doctrine. And guess what? Those lies got you in captivity. Read.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
So the whites of his eyes was red. Because what was the first miracle Christ did? Do you know? What you think he did with that wine?
Huh?
He drank that wine. Read. That's why when we drink wine, don't the whites of our eyes turn red?
Right.
Read that again.
And his eyes were as a flame of fire.
Read.
And his feet like a divine brand.
Look, since I can look at your feet and tell what color is it, right? He said his feet was like what?
Like a divine brand.
What color is brass?
Brass?
Yeah.
Like a bronze?
A bronze. Bronze is what? Brown. Bronze is brown. Because look, if you was in the Olympics, you had the gold medal, silver medal, and bronze medal. One is already gold. What color is the bronze? It's brown. It's a derivative of brown. But let's find out how brown Christ was. Read.
As if they burned in a furnace.
His feet look like they what?
As if they burned in a furnace.
You burn anything, what color is it?
It's black.
That's so guess right. What? Our Lord and Savior is a black man. Give me one
question.
He's a black man. And what do you think that black man is coming back to do? Huh? He coming back to do what? You damn right he's coming back.
That's right.
Because his people need saving.
Right.
The other nations need saving. So the white man needs saving.
Freedom.
That's what this Bible is all about. And the Bible is giving you the history of our people going in and out of captivity.
Right.
It's telling you why we went into captivity. It's telling you that we kept committing sin. We kept breaking God's law. And guess what? When we repented and turned back to God, God would bring us out of captivity. Are we in slavery now?
Yeah.
Guess what? We need saving out of this slavery.
That's
this
right.
is our final slavery.
Right.
And guess what? Here's the reason why Christ came on this earth. Read.
Luke chapter 1, verse 68. Blessed be the Lord God of Israel.
Of who?
Of Israel.
The so-called black, Hispanic, Native American. We are the children of Israel. Don't never let nobody call you a color again.
That's right.
You are an Israelite from the tribe of Judah. Be proud of that.
Read. That's
right. For he hath visited and redeemed his people.
He has visited and did what?
Redeemed his people.
Read.
And hath raised up an horn of salvation for us in the house of his servant David.
That's our Lord Jesus Christ, the black Messiah.
Read.
That's right. As he spake by the mouth of this holy prophet.
Uh-huh.
Which have been since the world began.
That what?
That we should be saved from our enemies.
We should be what?
Be saved from our enemies.
Hey, black man, black woman, if you don't want to be saved from your enemies, you must be a damn happy slave. You must be a happy slave. Christ is coming back to save his people.
That's
period. Right. Why don't you want that? You want to stay on the streets? You happy in the conditions we in? You happy seeing our people get shot down the street? You happy them begging the white man for a sandwich? Begging him for some crumbs? The earth is given to us to rule.
Bring it up.
The earth is given to us to rule. All you gotta do is return back to him, period.
Right.
Do you know how to return back to Christ? Yes, repent. Do you know how to repent?
Bring it out.
Do you know how to repent? Give me that first key.
Bring it out.
I'm going to show you how to repent.
Bring it out.
Because then listen, once you understand that, hey, that's our Savior. You understand you're an Israelite. You understand that, hey, you got to repent. This Bible is a process. This whole thing is a process. You understand? You got to come and start learning. You understand? Get that. Give me Hebrews 5 and 12. You got to start learning. You got to start congregating. Today is the Sabbath of the Lord.
Right.
Today is the day that God said, my children come and worship me. You know what I'm saying? Come and worship him. Because on Sunday, guess where all our people going to be at? In them churches worshiping this man right here.
That's right.
They're going to be worshiping a dead white man that was a homosexual.
Right.
That's who they're going to be worshiping on Sunday. Read.
Hebrews chapter 5 and verse 12.
Uh-huh.
But when for the time he ought to be teaching.
Brother man, listen, you at the age where you should be out here teaching our people.
That's
right. You should be teaching our people. Read.
Ye have need that one teach you again.
You have need that what?
That one teach you again.
You have need that one teach you again. You know what that's called, sis? Being reborn again. That's what it's called. You gotta be reborn again. You gotta humble yourself as a little child and be taught all over again. And what must you be taught? Read.
Which be the first principles of the oracles of God.
You gotta learn the first principles. You gotta learn the milk of the word. You gotta learn the basics. You understand? That's how you gonna grow. By drinking what? Milk. That babies drink milk, they grow.
Bring it out.
Come in and start learning the simple basics of these laws. That's it. Now give me 1 Kings. Let's show you repentance.
1 Kings chapter 8, verse 46. If they sin against thee, for there is no man that sinneth not.
You sinned against God. We all sinned against God. We was all walking in our wickedness. We all did. Hey, we all was sitting there serving the same white man right here.
Dude.
We heard somebody bring out the word of God. And when we heard that, you know what we did? Just like you brought out earlier. We turned our feet to the testimony. We listened to the word of Christ. We repented. That's where you at right now. You sitting there saying, you know what? I'm hearing this word for the first time. You know what? God said, choose you this day whom you're going to serve. You understand? You're going to keep serving the white man. You're going to go celebrate Mother's Day. Mother's Day when tomorrow? You're right. Hey, they come to you with that Mother's Day, tell them you only serving God.
That's right.
Tell them you only serving God. You ain't doing that no more. You through with that. Don't nobody need to honor you. You need to be honoring God. Because that's what you've been serving your whole life. This devil right here.
That's right.
You don't need nobody serving you. Right. It's time for you to turn to the Most High. Right. Read.
And thou be angry with them.
And God was angry with us. Read.
And deliver them to the enemy.
God did what?
Deliver them to the enemy.
We was delivered to the enemy. You got that poster? Turn that around right quick. This is how we was delivered to our enemy. Right there. On them slave ships. We was delivered to the enemy. Read.
So that they carried them away captives unto the land of the enemy.
We was carried away captives. We was brought out of the land of Israel and took where? Scattered all over the earth. All over the earth. This is Bible prophecy being fulfilled. Us being brought over here in slave ships. This is how you know this Bible is real.
Right.
But our people think it's a white man's book. This is their history.
That's right.
Our people are running away from their history. They're running away from the knowledge and wisdom that's going to bring us out of slavery.
Right.
Read.
Far or near.
Uh-huh.
Yet, if they shall bethink themselves.
If they do what?
If they shall bethink themselves.
Are you thinking about yourself now, sis? You're thinking about your life. Is you now saying, you know what? I'm an Israelite. You been thinking yourself right now.
Right.
You pondering like, damn, what have I been doing? Have you not saying that?
Get out of my head.
You saying it. Because you know why we know? Because we said it.
Right. Right.
We said it.
That's right.
It ain't nothing new that we bringing out that we ain't did ourselves. Read.
In the land whither they were carried captives.
Uh-huh.
And repent.
And do what?
And repent.
That means you got to turn away from your sin. You know one of the first things you can do, sis, to turn away from your sin when you get home? Put on a dress.
That's right.
Have you had, they touched on that? Hey, that's one step of repentance.
That's
put
right.
on a dress. You know what I'm saying? Days of Sabbath. Don't go home cooking. Don't go to the stores buying nothing. Celebrate the Lord. Like right. I said, we right a few blocks away. 1823 Gregg Street. Guess what we're going to be doing? We're going to be there with our families serving God. Read.
And make supplication unto thee in the land of them that carried them captives.
That's a heartfelt plea to God. Say, you know what, God, I've been a sinner. I've been wicked. You know, if you at my age, guess what? I've only been awake for about 10 so more years. I've been keeping these laws. Guess what? For all those other years, I was wicked as hell. So I had to make that plea to God. Say, please forgive me. I didn't know. You didn't know. Because why? Our enemies gave us a lie, and we trusted in our enemy. We believed the lie that our enemy gave us. Now you got to start recognizing what that enemy, what he's really about. He's the devil that the Bible speaks of.
That's right.
Read.
Say, we have sinned.
Saying what?
Say, we have sinned.
That's the first step in the repentance, is admitting you sinned against God. Read.
And have done perversely.
What have we done?
We have committed wickedness.
We have done what?
Committed wickedness.
Mother's Day is wicked.
That's right.
Christmas is wicked.
That's right.
Thanksgiving is wicked.
That's
going
right.
Going to church on Sunday is wicked.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? Hey, going from man to man to man, wicked.
Right.
That's all we've been taught. That's all we ever known. But we had to do something. You at the end of that? Yo, man.
And so return unto thee with all their heart.
We got to do what?
Return unto thee with all their heart.
We got to return back to God with all of our heart.
That's
you know how
right.
You going to do that? Go, give me Isaiah 34 and 16. All we got to do is something very simple. Simple things to return to God with all our heart. And that's the first thing is the fearing. You know how you fear God? By opening up this book. Opening up this book. And stop trusting everybody that tell you about God, but trust in the word of God.
Right, read. That's right.
Isaiah chapter 34, verse 16.
Read up.
Seek ye out of the book of the Lord.
And what?
And read.
And do what?
And read.
Go home, sis. Open up this book and start reading.
Right.
You're going to read the greatest story in the history of mankind.
Right.
You're going to read the story about your people.
Right. Right.
We are the greatest people. We are the children of prophets, children of kings. We are the children of God.
That's right.
You understand that? We royalty on this earth. Read.
No one of these shall fail.
Not one of these prophecies is going to fail. You return back to God, guess what? Christ is going to save you. That won't fail.
Right.
Read.
None shall want her mate.
You ain't going to be able to compare any book to this Bible. Read.
For my mouth it hath commanded.
Who mouth?
My mouth it hath commanded.
God commanded this book.
That's
God, these are the words of God. No ordinary man could have told you these things. No ordinary man could have predicted that we would go on slave ships, that we would serve our enemies. No ordinary man, guess what, is going to tell you how to get the hell out of slavery. No man is going to show you how to do that, but the word of God will.
That's
the word of God will show you how to come out these conditions.
Right.
So do you believe? Do you love God? He only asks you to do one thing. Give me that 1 John 5. He only asks you to do one thing, and that's something. All we got to do, because guess what? You know what we've been doing? We've been obeying the white man the whole damn time we've been here.
Right.
That's why we celebrate Christmas.
Right.
That's why we celebrate Thanksgiving.
Right.
That's why we went to church on Sunday. Because
right.
The white man told us.
Right.
But now you say you love God? What God say this right here?
1 John chapter 5 and verse 3.
Read it up.
For this is the love of God.
That we what?
That we keep his commandments.
That we do what?
That we keep his commandments.
Don't let that go home and say, you know what? I like what they were saying. But you know what?
It's God stuck with me. I done had 4 of my buses passed
by. All praises, sis. God wants you to change. He called you here. Hey,
right.
You got to believe this. Nothing is an accident. Read again from the top.
For this is the love of God,
uh-huh.
That we keep his commandments.
That we do what?
That we keep his commandments.
Read.
And his commandments are not grievous.
Ain't nothing hard about keeping the commandments, sis. They're easy. They're very easy. All you gotta do is do it. Come join your people. Hey, guess what? We your family. We're gonna help uphold you. We're gonna make sure
That's
we
right.
keep these laws.
That's
you know
right.
what I'm saying? Hey, so hey, feel good about that thing. Give me Deuteronomy 7 and 6. Feel good. Because guess what? You never heard the truth. You never heard how to get salvation. They told you all you had to do is what? Call on the name of God. Praise his name. As if this old big old Bible, you could have just wrote that in one sentence. That's all we had to do.
What?
We'd have been doing that. We've been doing that. We in hell. Catching hell all over the earth.
Yeah. Right.
Sis, I'm glad you're up here. You know your nationality? You know your nationality?
I'm black.
Guess what, sis? That sweat on, that's black.
Right.
I look at your skin, and you what? Brown.
Right.
Guess what our people don't know? Give me Hosea 4 and 6. I'm going to give you something very simple. Watch it. Very simple. This is to find out truth today. You know what our people don't know? The truth. You ever heard this? You should know the truth, and the truth should set you free. You know what we didn't ask? What the truth was. Our people don't care. Go ahead, Hosea 4:6.
Hosea chapter 4 and verse 6. My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge.
He said, my people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge. They don't even know who they are.
Right.
They said they're a color in the crayon box. A color in the crayon box. You understand that? Go back to Deuteronomy 7:6. I'm going to show you something God said about you.
Deuteronomy chapter 7 and verse 6.
Read up.
For thou art an holy people unto the Lord thy God.
God has a chosen people. He said they holy to him, meaning he separated those people from all the people of the earth. You understand? Holy means to be separate. So he said, I separated my children from all the people of the earth. Read.
For the Lord thy God had chosen thee to be a special people.
He said, I've chosen you to be special. Are we not special? That's the white man. Is the white man special? Can he sing like you?
Yeah, I know that.
Read up. Style like you. He got flavor like you. Do he got the speed we got? The strength we got? Do he got the swag that we got? There's something special about us because we got all of that.
That's right.
Read.
Above all people.
Hey, he said we're above what?
Above all people that are upon the face of the earth.
He said we're above all people upon the face of the earth.
That's right.
How can the children of God be above all people who he done blessed with all these special abilities, all this character, all these traits? How do we get to be at the bottom?
Bring it out. Bring it out.
Go back to Hosea 4 and 6. Watch this.
Hosea chapter 4 and verse 6. My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge.
If you ain't got knowledge, that means you slow. He said, my people are destroyed for the lack of knowledge. Read.
Because thou hast rejected knowledge.
What did our people do?
Because thou hast rejected knowledge.
The blacks, Hispanics, and Native Americans are the children of Israel.
That's
you
right.
See yourself on the left hand side is what the enemy calls us. If you consider yourself a African-American, black, then you from the tribe of Judah.
That's right.
Judah is the same tribe that Jesus Christ come from.
That's
King
right.
David come from. King Solomon come from.
Right.
Guess what, sis? You royalty and they don't even know it.
That's right.
You traded in that royalty for a color in a crayon box that you didn't even know was round.
Right.
You claim to be black because the white man told you you was black. Because the white man said you was African-American. Because the white man called you a Negro. White man also called you a coon, a porch monkey, and all that shit too.
Right.
But guess what? God called you Judah.
That's right.
That's what God called you. Read.
Because thou hast rejected knowledge.
What did our people do?
Thou hast rejected knowledge.
Guess what? We know that's a fact. Because you know how you know our people rejected knowledge? Look at our people now. They rejected the knowledge of God. Nobody want to hear the word of God. But they said they love God. Who the hell ever said, I love somebody, then when they come to them, you don't want to deal with them?
Right.
Hey, if you told a man that you love him and he don't want to deal with you, are you going to deal with that man again?
No.
God ain't dealing with our people.
Right.
Because they say they love him, and then he won't even hear the word of God.
Right.
Read.
I will also reject thee.
What would he do?
I will also reject thee.
He rejected us because we didn't hear the word of God. Read.
That thou shalt be no priest to me.
All the men of God are called to be the priest of God.
Right.
Guess what? Have you seen black men ever out here teaching in the streets? We the priest of God. We the prophets of God. Giving you the word of God. Telling you the truth. Telling you who you are. Have your pastors ever told you that you was an Israelite? That you was God's chosen people? No, you know why you didn't know? You know why they didn't tell you? Because they served that man.
Right.
They served that man. They served a white Christ, a lie. They served the devil that the Bible speaks of.
Right.
We're the only people that don't have a God that look like us. We're the only people that serve other people.
Right.
Because why? We just read everyone on top again.
My people are destroyed for a lack of knowledge.
That's why you would serve another God, because you destroyed for the lack of knowledge. And black people hate to read. We won't even open up a book to start reading. We won't even slow our ass down to hear the word of God.
Right.
Read.
Because thou hast rejected knowledge.
Read.
I will also reject thee.
He said he would do what?
Also reject thee.
If we're in the ghettos, we catch the hell all over the earth. Do you think we've been rejected? Exactly. Because guess what? If your children don't want to follow you, they don't want to do what you say, you kick them out the house and say, you on your own. Look at them. They on their own. Now they out here begging in the streets. The children of God, the ones that were created to be gods on this earth, now out here begging for a handout. Now I'm here begging for a job. Jeez. Now we are here catching buses.
Right.
We once ruled this earth. They used to be our servants.
That's right. Right.
We should be pissed off at that. Read.
That thou shalt be no priest to me.
Read.
Sing, thou hast forgotten the law of thy God.
What did we forget?
The law of thy God.
We've forgotten the laws of God.
Right.
The laws of God. Guess what? You had any kids? You a child? Did your mother and father give you rules to follow? Guess what? You work for a living, right? So, hey, them rules must have worked. It's like you're trying to be somebody.
Shalom, Israel. This is Bishop Nathaniel. I want you to know that you can view all our Sabbath classes live on Iuic TV. That's right. I said on Iuic TV. Download the app today. Shalom.
Deuteronomy chapter 4 and verse 5.
Uh-huh.
Behold, I have taught you statutes and judgments.
Read.
Even as the Lord my God commanded me.
Read.
That ye should do so in the land whither ye go to possess it.
So God, when he gave us the most precious land on earth, guess what our God gave us? He gave us laws to follow. He gave us commandments to follow. And he said, look, here's the laws. You do these. You break these laws. I have judgments for breaking these laws. Guess what? Your parents gave you law, rules to follow. Wasn't there judgments when you broke it? Yeah. Guess what? This right here, us out here on this cotton field, us getting hung, that's the judgment of God. He told us these things was gonna happen before they ever happened.
That's right.
Read. Hey, brother, what we're doing right now is showing that we are the children of God, that we are the children of the book. Now, we are the Israelites.
That's
those
right.
are the children of God.
Right.
And God gave his children wisdom to rule this earth. Wouldn't you think God would do that for his children? Give them knowledge to rule the earth? He wouldn't give his children knowledge to be servants to the white man.
Right.
He gave them knowledge to rule the earth, knowledge to govern their households, to raise their children, how to treat their wives, how to treat their brothers. Read.
No, I gotta go home.
Keep them for and do them.
So he said, I gave you law, statute, commandments. He said, keep therefore and do them. Read.
For this is your wisdom.
This is your what?
Your wisdom.
He said, these law, statute, commandments is for your wisdom.
Read.
Right. Hey, brother, y'all got time to hear the word of God? That lets you know we don't have wisdom. Because when the word of God come out, our people ain't got time for it.
Right.
Hey, thank God you stop. What's your name?
Ken.
My name is Juanathan. And hey, guess what? You're an Israelite.
That's right.
Do you see yourself on the sign? Which one would you call yourself? American Black, West Indian, Haitian, American Black.
Allahu Akbar.
Judas.
Yeah, right.
Allahu Akbar.
Yeah, God is great,
yes,
but he's the God of Israel.
That's right. Keep them for and do them.
He said, do what?
Keep them for and do them.
God said, I gave you laws and commandments. Keep them for and do them. Read.
For this is your wisdom.
This is your what?
Your wisdom.
God gave us laws, statutes, commandments for your wisdom. Read.
And your understanding.
Uh-huh.
In the sight of the nation.
He said, this is going to be your understanding in the sight of the nation. I'm giving you my wisdom. I'm going to make you the wisest people on earth to rule the earth. Read.
Which shall hear all these statutes
uh-huh.
and say, surely this is a great nation.
This is a what?
This great nation.
Guess what? We're coming back to God's law. You know what they see? They see the rise of that great nation. You understand? The rise of the Israelites is happening right here on earth right now. We're coming back to God. We're coming back to his law. We're out here teaching our people
to
stop being a whoremonger, stop being a drug dealer, how to love your brother, how to love your sister, how to raise up a family in righteousness. That is what's going on right now.
Right.
And now, and guess what? Your enemy hates that. Because they know by you coming back to God's law, it's the downfall of their kingdom. They understand that. Give me Deuteronomy 28:1. Watch this. They understand what's happening. They see it. And fear is going throughout this earth right now. Read.
Deuteronomy 28:1. And it shall come to pass, if thou shalt hearken diligently unto the voice of the Lord thy God, to observe and to do all his commandments.
To do all those commandments that he gave you for your wisdom this day. He said, if you do all these commandments, what?
Which I command thee this day, that the Lord thy God will set thee on high above all nations of the earth.
He said, I'm going to put you over the whole earth. Do you think the white man is stronger than God? Exactly. He is not. So the white man got to lie to you. He got to lie to you. He got to get you to serve them. Because who was you taught this was? You was taught this was Christ, right? You was taught this was Christ. Hey, what's your last name? I'll praise you. You come from the tribe of Judah. Read.
And all,
go ahead.
And all these blessings shall come on thee and overtake thee.
He said, you know what? If you keep my law, that commandments, I'm going to see you. I'm going to send you so much blessings, you ain't going to be able to handle the blessings.
That's right.
Jump down to verse 10.
Verse 10. And all people of the earth shall see that thou art called by my name.
He said, all the people, the whites, the Chinese, the Africans, they're going to see that y'all are called by my name, that you are the children of God, that you are the Israelites. And what?
Of the Lord, and they shall be afraid of thee.
They're gonna be what?
Afraid of thee.
They're gonna be afraid of you.
Yes, sir.
They're gonna be afraid of you because they know that their end is at hand. But obviously, we at the bottom, right? Why are we at the bottom? Give me verse 15.
Deuteronomy 28:15. But it shall come to pass, if thou wilt not hearken unto the voice of the Lord thy God.
He said, but if you don't hearken to my voice, you don't do what?
To observe, to do all his commandments.
He said, if you don't keep those commandments that I gave you as my children, he said, if you don't keep these commandments, read.
And his statutes, which I command thee this day,
uh-huh.
That all these curses.
All these what?
All these curses.
He said, I'm going to send curses, read.
Shall come upon thee and overtake thee.
He said, I'm going to send curses on you. They're going to overtake you. Is a curse a good thing or a bad thing? Hey, is it a good thing or a bad thing? A curse?
Oh,
so what? Hold on. Give me verse 46.
Verse 46. And they shall be upon thee for a sign.
So he said them curses is going to be upon you for a sign. You know what? A sign does what? Identify something, right? So guess what? He said the curse is going to be on you for a sign. Read.
And for a wonder
uh-huh.
upon thy seed forever.
So he said the curse is going to be upon you for a sign and upon your children forever.
Right.
That's how you're going to know that you're an Israelite. Because the curses came on the children of Israel. Go to verse 16. Watch this.
Verse 16. Curse shall thou be in the city.
Hey, you know how you cursed in the city? Because you out here catching the damn bus.
Right.
Instead of being a king on this earth.
That's
you,
right.
Hey, you too busy trying to get to where you gotta go. You stay out here in the word of God. That's how you know you cursed. Guess what? You can always go serve the damn white man. Or you can always, you know what, take the time and say, let me learn how to serve God so I can make the white man be my servant.
That's right.
You could take that approach. Because I guarantee you, the white men, you know what? They took the time to say, I'm gonna learn how to bring the niggas down. Give me that, Judah 5. I'm gonna show you that. The white man sat back and said, hold up. We're gonna bring them down. We're gonna make them suffer. We're gonna put them in slavery. And this is how they did it. Watch this. Yeah.
Judah 5:20.
Keep this out. This is how the white man plotted to take us down. Because they saw something in you and they knew how to take you down. Read.
Now therefore, my Lord and Governor, if there be an error in this people, if they sin against their God.
If they do what?
And they sin against their God.
They say if they people sin against their God, read.
Let us consider that this shall be their ruin.
This shall be their what?
Their ruin.
He said if they sin against their God, this is going to be that people's downfall. Because we're not strong enough to take them down. We can't defeat them as long as they're serving God. Read.
And let us go up. And we shall overcome them.
He said, if they sin against their God, let's go to war against them.
Right.
Let's take them down. Read.
But if there be no iniquity in their nation.
And he said, but if it ain't no sin amongst them, read.
Let my Lord now pass by.
He said, leave them to hell alone. Let's keep walking. Read.
Lest their Lord defend them.
Who shall defend us?
Lest their Lord defend them.
Because when you're keeping God's laws, God is going to defend you.
That's right.
We can stand up here boldly. Why? Because we keep the laws of God.
That's right.
We ain't worried about no man. We ain't worried about our own. We ain't worried about our enemy. Because we done came back to serve God. And that's right. All you have to do, sis. Come back to serve God, and he will make your way possible.
We used to scream black power while Heron was pushed. But at the end of the day, nothing's in vain. Iuic has been given a vision. The tents of Judah has risen. Many has attempted the mission, minor murmuring, omitting, and missing the mark. Just reading that he had the flame of fire in his eyes gave us the spark. We on Paul's mission. We out on the road, purple and gold, from Mexico, Cuba, Haiti, Ghana, Sierra Leone. 144,000 boots banging, concrete crackling. These are how our men repented at heart. The scriptures is proof. Iuic, we deliver the truth.